Motown is known for its legendary roster of songwriters. Icons like Holland Dozier Holland, Smokey Robinson, Janie Bradford, Harvey Fuqua, and many more. All of these writers were African American, shaping the soulful sound of Motown that became a cultural phenomenon. But there's one songwriter you may not be familiar with, even though you've heard his songs, which have been covered by countless artists and remain an unforgettable part of music's golden era. I'm speaking of Ron Miller, Motown's first white songwriter, a man whose talent brought heartfelt stories and emotions to life through song. Ron Miller's journey began in the 1960s. It has been said that he was discovered by Berry Gordy while playing at a piano bar in Chicago. Another source states that it was Mickey Stevenson who first made the discovery. However, what is known to be true is in 1963, Miller became the first white songwriter at Motown. One of his most iconic works was For Once in My Life, written in 1965 and popularized by Stevie Wonder in 1967. This song has its own story, which we'll cover in my next video. Miller's work with Stevie Wonder didn't stop there. He wrote several other hits, including A Place in the Sun. Yestermy, Yester You, Yesterday. Someday at Christmas.
Someday at Christmas, men won't be boys playing with bombs like.
And Heaven Help Us All.
Heaven help the child who never had a home. Heaven help the girl who walks the streets alone. Heaven help the roses.
Miller also contributed unforgettable songs to other Motown artists. Touch Me in the Morning by Diana Ross.
Then just walk away. We don't have tomorrow.
And I've Never Been to Me by Charlene.
Out of places and friendly faces because I had to be free.
His talent extended beyond Motown, penning hits like Can We Try by Teddy Pendergrass.
Can we try? Love was never born to say goodbye. Just another helpless fool in love.
And If I Could, recorded by Nancy Wilson and other artists.
If I could, I'd protect you from the sadness in your eyes.
Sadly, Ron Miller passed away on July 23, 2007. And he was described by his daughter Lisa as a young Jewish songwriter with a very Rodgers and Hammerstein musical theater writing style, who wrote of peace and hope for a better tomorrow during a time of war and the civil rights movement. He didn't just write about it, he lived it. Ron Miller's contributions to Motown proved that a great song has no color. And his lyrics remind us that music truly unites us all.